right now. An interesting conversation Bill had with local financial advisor JB Bryan about something we would love to daydream about, retiring early.
Did you know that a recent U.S. News and World Report reveals 50% of all Americans end up retiring earlier than expected? Financial advisor JB Bryan is here to explain how you can prepare for the unexpected. And we welcome her back to our live show. Good morning. Good to see you.
It's great to see you, Bill. I think that those numbers are really high. 50% of people retiring earlier than anticipated. That's some big numbers there.
Well, you spend your whole day and your whole week and month and year advising people on how to get ready for this. And that kind of, that number kind of caught me off guard too. But nonetheless, we'll deal with it. So I'm sure there are reasons, many reasons. Can we boil it down to three big reasons why people are retiring early?
And unfortunately, thank you for asking that, because unfortunately the top reason is health. Health issues are actually forcing many people to leave the workplace way earlier than they anticipated. So, and this has been, you know, the biggest reason, just health issues. And then that was backed up by other health issues in the family. Maybe it's a parent, a spouse, or even taking care of grandchildren. But that's a second reason. Of the top three, you know, it's just they're losing their job. Many people have lost their job, been forced out of the workplace, got fired, or the job was terminated or ended.
Yeah. So you mentioned health is probably the number one reason, which to me sounds right, because fortunately for me, I've always had a job I loved. I always look forward to going in. So, and I'll stay here until they drag me out, which they may at one point. You know, they're like, okay, get him out. Send him away. So I'm planning on working until, you know, I'm not going to set that date. But if you get sick or if you've got major problems, then you're not able to do that anymore.
That's what happens.
Yeah.
And, you know, what we've talked about this really before, how important it is to take care of yourself. Because the financial impact of early retirement is tremendous. Even if you just have to take your Social Security at 62, you know, think about what you're losing by not waiting until the full retirement age of 70. That's a big hit on your pocket, as well as just having to use your own savings earlier than you anticipated. So, I mean, if you're taking several of your working years away from you, that also means you're taking away several of your saving and investing years away from you as well. So,
you mentioned health, and then just people just, you know, especially with the pandemic, jobs have been eliminated, obviously. There's a lot of them have gone away.
But, Bill, think about people leaving, and they're not 65, so they don't have that big part. That healthcare isn't covered until you're 65 under your Social Security. So if you're retiring at 62, you're going to take a chunk of your money to cover just health care expenses.
Yeah. So you put those two factors together, that they're quitting because of their health and the fact that they can't be on Medicare yet.
True.
That's a huge hit on whatever savings you've got.
And this is not a sad thing for everyone that's sharing this time with us. Like, this is a good thing, because there are steps that you can take. Because if we're saying that 50% of us will have to retire unexpectedly earlier than you thought, then there's things that you can do. Like, we need to take care and have a healthy lifestyle. You know, we need to make sure, as Bill mentioned, enjoy your work, reduce your stress. And then, because there's no guarantee, because there's really, like, anything could happen. We're living in a pandemic, living through a pandemic. So there are, you know, things that we need to do to take our health seriously, to protect ourselves, and to take your retirement savings and investing very seriously.
All right. I don't want to nail you down on one specific group, but let's say you're 50 years old and you're working and you have to quit for your health, or your job gets a little, well, let's say you're working right along. Things are clicking along and you're saying, well, I'm going to retire when I'm 65. And then you need to make plans just in case. That's you right. know, you, either the job gets eliminated or health goes south.
That's right. Because even if you qualify for disability income, it does not replace your income that you were making previously at work. So you're going to, you know, have to adjust your lifestyle in order to avoid going into your savings and investing more. And as we've mentioned, most workers are not saving enough for their long-term financial goals. So this discussion, I hope, will be encouraging that we need to take our future seriously. We need to be as positive as possible, but also proactive about saving, investing, and staying healthy, and protecting and communicating to your family and anticipating what your family needs may be.
Yeah, so that kind of boils down to plan for the best and prepare for the worst.
Great, yeah. I love it. You are amazing. That's the financial plan, that's it.
We get that printed on a coffee mug and it might help push back our retirement. So listen, you do this all the time. Is it your sense that people are starting to get the message, or is it still kind of like, oh no, that couldn't happen to me?
Well, the most amazing thing about my career is that when I started in financial services about 30 years ago, people were retiring in their 40s, when I thought that they were old. I remember that. And I said, oh, wow, it didn't stand out to me that here I have a person retiring at 48 years old. I have clients today in their 70s that have been retired for my entire career almost. So, Bill, now we're in a time that is totally different within my career.
That doesn't even sound realistic at this
amazing.
Point in time. It's like, wait a minute, when was that?
I know, right? That was in the 90s.
Wow.
That was in the 90s. But what happened, Bill, the pensions went away. Mm-hmm. They were leaving because they were getting an early pension. The corporations were encouraging them to leave, giving them additional service years to get them off the books. And they would compliment, but the pension is the key difference. Now, most of you working, your companies are reducing your pension coverage or getting rid of it altogether. Major corporations are getting rid of their pension, putting more of a match to your 401ks. So that means that you are responsible for your retirement and your financial future today more than ever.
I think I'm just as likely to run into a Martian on the sidewalk as I am to run into somebody who can retire 48 nowadays. Thank you, JB. I'll be looking for that little green man out on the sidewalk. JB Bryant offers free weekly money seminars and webinars every Wednesday evening and Sunday morning. You'll find a link for more information at WTVR.com/VTM. And stay tuned. We will be right back.